Hello. Welcome to Dan Explains It All. Today we're here to talk about expression ramper. Expression ramper is a way of moving your expression values, making your parameters shift around. It's, I don't know how you put it. Let's start with talking about expression. You might be familiar with it. It's on a lot of old blood pedals. Basically, if there's an expression input, you can plug in a TRS cable and plug in the other end of that TRS cable to something like an expression pedal or our expression slider and manipulate a particular parameter with your hand or your foot just in a different way than turning the knob. Expression ramper takes over that same TRS connection, but it lets you set how high it can go, how low it can go. It creates movement between those two positions and how fast that movement is and whether it stops when it reaches one point. It's basically a way of doing a ton of expression automation with a simple click of a foot switch. So like the rest of the utility line, Expression Ramper is all about coaxing new sounds out of your existing setup. To do that, I guess we should probably hear something. Let's start with the reflector. If I set it to wrinkle mode and turn the rate and depth down so we don't have much chorusing happening, modulate controls the pitch, but we have the expression ramper set to control the modulate control. So with that sound available, let's dive into how to work the Old Blood Noise Endeavor's expression ramper. If I set this toggle to A, it's our AB rate toggle, it allows me to set the A position, indicated by this pink LED here. I can go all the way down, which on the wrinkle mode is an octave down. I can go all the way up, which is going to be an octave up. I can max out my mix if I only want to hear that, but we'll keep some of the main signal in. So let's set A all the way down. Now we'll move our toggle to B. The moment I move the knob, you'll see the LED change color to match the cyan of the B setting. And I'll bring that all the way up to the octave up. So now we've heard the overall range of it, but what if we want to set it in motion? Just hit the foot switch. Now it's moving back and forth between A and B. It's a pretty wild amount of pitch shifting. So maybe we slow it down and hear it kind of climb slowly and drop slowly. To do that, we'll move to the rate control. And again, move this primary knob. So you'll notice this knob sets every single setting on the A, B, and rate toggle. Just pick which one you want to control. Can get really fast. All the way down to so slow that it sounds disgusting in most of the travel given this particular setting. We'll revisit that later. So that's the basic functionality of the AB rate toggle and the knob that sets each of those things. So now let's look at this toggle on the left. You'll notice it's set to the triangle shape. That means when we turn our LFO on, off, on, off, on, it has a linear motion. It's like a triangle shape. It moves up and down at the rate you've decided. But what if you wanted to just skip between an octave up and an octave down with that same timing? Switch it to square. So now we're on the square mode, and you'll hear it simply move between that octave down and the octave up. Or you could even, let's say, go back to A and make that a unison note. Just whatever your settings are, it'll move between those in a square shape. I'll go ahead and bring A all the way back down. Kick it on again. So that leaves us with just one shape left, and that is labeled A to B, what we call the one-shot mode. What this does is stop when it reaches either the A or the B. You hit the foot switch, and it moves to the other, stays there. One more time, back to A, up to B, and it just stays there and is essentially moving between the two at the exact same rate as you've set before, so you'll notice it doesn't instantaneously move there, but of course if we max out our rate, it will. Very fast, one shot, perhaps a very slow one shot. It's just a nice way to make those changes gradual, but not in a way where the LFO is constantly moving. So you can just set it in motion and let it arrive. That's really what Expression Ramper does. That is the entire control set. It's deceptively simple in a way, because again, it is all about getting new sounds out of existing expression setups. For example, here I could detune A slightly, detune B slightly in the opposite direction, and it'll sound kind of gross at both of those settings. But if we move between the two in a triangle wave, suddenly it's a deep vibrato type sound. It makes Reflector a double chorus in the pitch mode. I could put in our main chorus and speed up the rate on Expression Ramper so that it's changing how fast that pitch shifts. Turn it back and it's just that detuned single warble. And now both. So those are all new sounds you can coax out of just the wrinkle mode in our Reflector. So now that we're wiggling, let's hear Expression Ramper with a different pedal. How about Dweller? Here's the sound of Dweller with no motion. It's just set to the A position of Expression Ramper. And these are the same settings we had on the Reflector, so just moving between sort of below noon and above noon at a given rate. Let's introduce that motion. Suddenly, you're shifting the stretch knob of Dweller in a way where it's creating all these artifacts with pitch shifting elements and kind of a sort of hissing, noisy something that you can't quite place, but it's what happens when you just move the stretch knob just a little bit. This was something that we've enjoyed doing, just kind of shifting stretch back and forth, and now there's finally a way to just automate it. Just hit Expression Ramper and move your stretch knob. I could bring in the rate knob to actually do the phase shifting elements of Dweller as well, and really pair these motions together. We could get really strange with it and bring A all the way down again, B all the way up again, set our rate very low, and start moving again. You hear pitches cascading down and cascading up because essentially stretch is just changing the time of a bunch of different delay lines. So when you think about moving your time knob, how it kind of pitches up or pitches down depending on whether you're going faster or slower with the time. And you'll even hear it like just there catch up with the phaser sounds where the stretch is all the way down and it's just a very resonant phaser noise. So that's some of the added strangeness you can get from Dweller. The Expression Ramper. It's just really nice. Let's keep moving through sounds and try out the Procession. A fun way to pair Expression Ramper with the Procession Reverb is to set it to the tremolo mode and pick a couple different tremolo speeds you want to move between. So let's pick our A position. Make that one fairly fast. Set B slower. And just speed up and slow down. Gives this extra little bit of motion to an already moving reverb. If I bring the rate up, you get kind of a strange galloping effect, almost like a polyrhythmic tremolo. Set it to square so it skips between the two. Or you could ramp it using the one-shot mode and set the rate a little slower and almost use it like a Leslie type effect where it steadily slows down or steadily speeds up. Set that rate even a little slower. So you can, yeah, just move between two different settings, but in a way that gradually affects that change. And again, this is something where, you know, you're playing and all you have to do is just quickly hit a switch and it'll move. You don't have to fine tune your expression pedal settings or reach down to move over and anything. You just hit the switch. Actually, that reminds me of something I was going to show you on the reflector and forgot. So let's do that. So while we're talking about using Expression Ramper to sort of create different presets, like the speed of the tremolo on the Procession, one of my favorite settings on the reflector is the wrinkle mode harmonized up to a fifth. So first, let's find that setting. I'm going to turn the rate and depth back down so it stops chorusing. Set the Expression Ramper to A and move my knob until I hear the harmony I'm looking for. Sounds really nice. So now I'll grab my B setting and make it just unison. I'm going to set my rate really fast, because what I want to do here is essentially create a preset with Expression Ramper. So I have my rate fast, my mode set to one shot, which means that when I hit that foot switch, it's just going to move very quickly to the other setting. So I've got it at B right now. I can see from the cyan LED. And then I want to bring in that fifth. And switch back. It's just a nice way of bringing a little added life and finding the exact harmony you're looking for instead of having to dial it in by hand with a slider or by foot with an expression pedal. You can just go straight there every time. So that's it. That's Expression Ramper. There's a lot in there. It's a simple control set and a small enclosure, and it just helps you bring more sounds out of your expression-enabled pedals. It takes 9-volt center negative power. It's working on a TRS connection currently, TRS that's active at the tip, because that's the setup we use, and a lot of other manufacturers do as well. But you can also configure it for TRS, where it's active at the ring, you know, the ring is connected to the wiper, or you can configure it just for TS connections, just tip and sleeve. By default, it ships with a B50K digital potentiometer. We found that 50K seems to be a value that works with a lot of manufacturers, Our Stuff, Maris, Chase Bliss, Boss, a lot of different manufacturers seem to use that, but you can also, with a solderless swap of that little digital pot, use a 10K value or a 100K value. And for more details on that, just head to the product page for the Expression Ramper. Okay, so that's it. That's Expression Ramper. Go forth, have fun, enjoy. I'm so sorry.